I grew up in Norway. I was born in a little town called Skui, which is about a half-hour drive from Oslo. And I grew up basically, what we did was play soccer, and I was doing music. Those are the two main things, and skiing, of course. I started pretty early on the piano, just improvising and figuring things out. I was self-taught for a long time until I eventually started reading music and having piano teachers and that kind of thing. My favorite thing to do as a child was definitely music. I listened to a lot of music, and my dad would also play a lot of music in the house. He's a very good amateur saxophonist. So I grew up with a sort of very eclectic music taste that my dad had. So from anything from ABBA to classical to jazz, and his background was in jazz. I guess that's probably where I got my sort of interest in improvisation from. I can't remember how I got started with my first teacher. I think I just wanted to learn how to read music, basically. But I could already sort of improvise and listen to things and play it back. So I had a pretty good ear as a child. I wasn't the easiest student, I think, because I just always wanted to do my own thing. My dad would help me in the beginning with composing as well, because he was used to arranging, you know, jazz and all that kind of stuff. Before I could write myself, I would just kind of dictate to him, play the lines, and he would write them down for me. So he was super, super helpful that way. I think I was very fond of Handel, actually. I love choral music, and I love Baroque music, and Mozart and Beethoven and all that. I love Brahms, especially Brahms, I think, like the Brahms Requiem, and eventually got more into Rachmaninoff, which is one of my absolute favorite composers. Somebody gave me a CD of Richter's recording of the second piano concerto, and that just blew me away. Eventually, my dad gave me a CD of the Keith Jarrett Kellen concert, just, you know, a whole CD of just completely improvised music. And that was another huge kind of milestone for me, to that somebody could do that, just improvise out of nothing for a whole concert, and the incredible energy and creativity that it was in that performance. That was really important to me. Later, I would start doing that myself as well. I mean, nowhere as good as Keith Jarrett. To me, Keith Jarrett is the greatest jazz pianist of all time. I grew up working on the synthesizer a lot. I think that the first group I was part of we started a kind of rock pop band in middle school. So that was my first experience. I would play the synthesizer. My first real synthesizer was, I think, in my early teens. My dad would take me to the Yamaha store that was like half hour from our house, and just let me go nuts on trying out all the synths for like a couple of hours on a Saturday afternoon, which is, it was like being in paradise. And then eventually my parents very kindly bought me my first real synth, which was a Yamaha SY-77, which was kind of it was a huge deal back then. That synthesizer was kind of revolutionary. I would work on that thing for hours and hours every day. And that was huge in kind of learning how to arrange music, because it has a sequencer, so you could record parts on top of each other and save them on this like floppy disk that you would put directly into the synthesizer. So that was so important in terms of learning how to arrange and compose and how things go together and what sounds good together. I also have a synthesizer teacher that I worked on those things with, who was really very good at, you know, making sounds also as well, not just using the factory sounds, that kind of thing. In Norway, the system is pretty different in terms of high school. So in America, most high schools have maybe a choir or band as well, maybe. But it's very different. In Norway, there is usually more a one dedicated music, dance, and drama high school in maybe one in each county, maybe, that are very specialized. So it's kind of almost like being at a music conservatory, and you work on music every day and in different different ways. So that's and there was a choir. You all had to attend choir there, which was a real blessing for me, because I never, even though I loved choral music, I'd never sung in a choir before, and I just loved it from the first second. I got my first classical composition teacher right after high school. Great teacher, great, like incredible knowledge, and his name is Wolfgang Plage. He's also very good at writing choral music and incredible understanding for it, so that's where we started off with me as well. And I think he also thought that that's the perfect kind of place to start for a classical composer, because it just kind of teaches you good voice leading and all that kind of stuff. So that's where we started, and then, but I kind of kept doing that because I love writing for choir so much. And he had a lot of pieces published by one of the major Norwegian publishers. So he was the one that pitched, you know, some of my pieces to them, and eventually got my first works published. My first 2 years of college was at the Norwegian Academy of Music in Oslo. Yeah, the reason I moved to the States was to, I got into the Juilliard School, because I'd never been to America before. That was my first time. And Juilliard is right in the middle of Manhattan, you know, which is such a wonderful location, and right at Lincoln Center, so that you were just like in the middle of all this great art. You know, it's just such an incredibly inspiring place to be and to be a student. After I finished my master's, I moved to Los Angeles. I studied film music for 1 year at USC, because film music has always been a huge deal to me. I love movies and television, but I also love soundtracks, you know, and a lot of them have been a really big influence on my own music. A lot of my favorite composers are film composers that work in Hollywood today. So I did 1 year of that at USC, and I loved it. But then I moved back to New York to start working full time as a concert music composer, basically. I knew I wanted to be a composer from when I was a little kid. So it was never like a choice, that I felt like I had no choice. You know, like it's just because it's that feeling that you just. You can't stop. So even if I wasn't doing it for a living, I wouldn't be able to not do it all the time. I always feel a huge gratitude to be able to do that, and to have the freedom to focus on being creative as much as possible.